All right, you guys want to learn how to fucking bounce your pecs?
Yeah! I'm about to show you.
Here's my credentials.
Now stop and just do it one big one. Whoa. We ride towards the fire. When the darkness is...
All right, so I'm gonna give you all the steps to learn.
What?
Yeah, all right. You should be able to put that in this video.
What? It was being able to fucking bounce my
Take number two. I'm gonna show you how to bounce your chest like a fucking pro. So anyway, step number one. We got diet right here. It's my first time trying this out, but it's some rice pudding. Anyways though, you gotta treat your body well, eat clean, and make sure you eat enough food to build muscle and be in a caloric surplus. So make sure that you're eating enough so that you can build muscle. Number two, okay? You gotta train consistently. You gotta eat consistently. You gotta keep showing up and not give up. So show up to the gym 4 to 5 times a week and don't only train chest, you know, it might help for this video, but don't do that. Number three, mind to muscle connection. You're gonna learn how to train your chest so much better when you just focus on squeezing and getting the stretch. So you'll see in my workout video later that when I'm doing flies, I'm really gonna try and control the chest, and I'm gonna squeeze at the top, and I'm not just dummying the weight around. Don't do that shit. Don't dummy it around unless you're going for a fucking PR. Mm-mm. Step number four, you gotta take Tren, all right? Blast that shit in your tit. No, I'm just kidding. Shit. Alright, I'm going out here.
It's cold as fuck.
Yo, it's cold as fuck, but look at this view, guys. This is Calgary right here. Anyways, step number four, you gotta get fucking stronger, okay? When you go and you work out, you're gonna work out and put up some heavy ass weight, but your next workout, you should be able to put up more weight or put up more reps. Either way, you're progressively overloading, and that will make your muscle get fucking bigger. You gotta explode the chest. Step number five, you have to get a juicy pump. Get that blood flow rushing in there, and it's so much easier to fucking connect your mind to your chest. Last tip of the day.
Take Tren.
No, don't take Tren. It's fucking practice your ass off. As weird as being able to pec bounce like fucking crazy, you just gotta practice. And every day, it was just like I would practice in the mirror. I'd be looking in the mirror and I would just be pec bouncing because I just wanted to. I don't know, it was never like a huge goal of mine, but I just did it and then I got better over time. Okay, that's it for the tutorial though, and the rest of the video is just gonna be a video of me fucking around, having fun, and me showing you what I train.
Chasing a sick pump, lifting heavy ass weight.
But the rest of the video is just gonna be fucking fun, vlogging, and showing you what I do for exercises, reps, and sets. So hope you fucking enjoy it. Dude, this looks like fucking really thick cum.
It is, bro. Goat cum.
Is that goat cum?
Yeah, don't tell anyone though. That's the secret to big pump.
You ready to lift some heavy ass weight?
I'm ready to fucking lift the barbell up and down and rip my muscle fibers apart. And then guess what I'm gonna do?
What?
Repair that shit and do it again.
Also guys, fucking look at this, bro. My like newest decoration. You ready to take some pre?
This fucking pre-workout is sponsored by Spitfire Nutrition. It's got fucking a lot of caffeine, I'll tell you that. It's got a lot of fucking L-citrulline.
8,000 milligrams.
The fucking pump you're gonna get from that fucking...
Take some pre.
Yeah,
one sec.
We gotta clean this thing out. This thing must probably smell like frogs.
Is it old?
Oh! I'm gonna 2-scoop that shit though.
2 scoops? No. No, no, there's no way. You're gonna, if you have 2 scoops, that's 600 milligrams of caffeine. Look, and that's 16,000.
Does it look like I give a fuck? Look at me.
Oh! Damn, I've never even took 2 scoops. Do I take 2? No.
Yes!
No, I don't do. I am not taking 2. I'm gonna do 1.5. Fucking run!
Beta! Yeah. Beta!
Call me a beta if you want.
Beta! I'm pushing all my arteries together.
Yeah!
got burned. We were alright, had the easy kind of love, and I let it in for a moment. Felt like we were floating, baby, I swear. We were golden, it was easy, natural as breathing air. And when the sky went dark, you think I would've known. Before we let it get this far, I should've let you go. Now I gotta crawl.
I love inclined cable flies. Reason being is because when you're back here, you have resistance on you all the time. Lather with dumbbells, you don't. Squeeze more and get that pump, that blood flow to learn how to bounce.
And when the sky went dark, you think I would've known. Before we let it get this far, I should've let you go. Now I gotta crawl.
I go really far back. It's actually bad for your shoulders, but I got really good shoulder mobility. So be careful with this, how far you go back, but get that stretch. Squeeze at the front. You're gonna thank me later.
So you love working out a lot, eh?
Yeah.
Like how much out of 10? You like it 10 out of 10?
10 out of 10.
So imagine working out on steroids.
On steroids?
An anabolic like fucking animal known to live.
You'd be like a big old grizzly bear. Got hair on my back and shit. Okay. So I just finished that crazy chest day. Look at that shit, bro. Bro, look at that. Like, this is just dummy. It's so important to eat after your workout to build the muscle back up. But you gotta eat food because some people will get lazy and they won't eat anything after, or they'll eat some junk, or they'll forget and not eat anything. As working out does not build muscle, it only breaks muscle. Food and sleep builds that shit back up and stronger and bigger and sexier. So with that being said, I'm gonna make a quick shake up.